This is Sway.
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 In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Don't shake your body.
Wake your fuck ass up.
That crust out your eyes.
Didn't you know about the elevator?
Y'all ain't selling them No Way products, are you?
Man, that was one of the funniest movies of the 80s. I'm going to get you, sucker. The brainchild of, in my opinion, one of the most brilliant hip-hop, comical collectives that we ever seen represented in a family. I love saying this. If you look at their legacy and all they've accomplished over the years, and they've done it as a family, they're like a comedy mafia, Heather B. You know, as much...
We're killing them with jokes!
You know what I mean? as much... We had Kim Fields on here today, and we talked about the impact she's had in our households. But the Wayans family, man.
You know, in the bathrooms, because we all love Tootie.
Tootie, yeah. Right?
Who didn't toot the Tootie?
Okay. And
even though she had braces, he's like, you know what? It may hurt a little bit. So what?
She like, she said, whoa.
Who said whoa?
The girl went, whoa. Heather,
I know you ain't whoa-ing. Girl, she take a sip of some vodka. You be all right.
You know what? Marvin know way too much. He already, Sean.
She like an old auntie. She keep vodka in places you didn't know you had it. Why you got vodka in your makeup kit?
Do that, Mom. Stop telling.
Vodka in your boobie.
Her beats by Dre is vodka.
The areola unscrew.
Wow.
Are you unscrewing the...
Wow. My nipple.
You unscrew it. Take a little sip. It's a flask.
Instead of breast milk.
Right. Instead of breast milk.
Forget the intro. The Wayan brothers are here.
Absolutely.
Man. Saying, man. Hey, man, y'all brought Damon with you this time, man.
We brought Damon with us.
Yeah.
Real.
We doing a tour. Okay. You know, gotta get out, dust it off, and get that funny back.
It's real.
Right. When the last time you been on tour, Damon?
I've honestly never really did a tour.
Okay.
This is like, because stand-up has always been kind of sacred to me. It's my therapy.
Yeah.
So to go out and make money off it, is, I don't know, it was like weird. But now,
that's
I'm
a
broke.
Lot of integrity.
No, I'm getting, not broke. I just the fact that we're all doing it together makes it sexy enough to, you know, leave the house.
Yeah, right? I think, I mean, and plus people always want to see you, man. Not that we don't want to see Shine and Marlon.
Yeah, you said that like we got.
Yeah, I'm trying to digest
really
this.
Want to see you?
Yeah, I'm trying to process what he's saying.
I don't
right
know
now.
Who the two little nappy Marlon Negroes
and
are.
And right.
Somebody want to see Tito and Jackie. TV, right. We want to see Michael.
Right.
It's almost like
even
that.
The hologram of Michael.
The hologram, right? Yo, was it like this in your childhood? Like, just everybody running around the house just telling jokes?
All day long.
Kind of.
Just like this. Except we didn't have electricity.
Yeah.
So you gotta feel our way around the house.
She made it sad. She's like, aw. Neither did I.
Probably make you a survivor. I'm so happy I grew up poor. I'm a survivor. I can make a meal out of anything, like MacGyver. You got what you got? You got flour and water?
Yeah.
You got some lard? We make some moolah mush right there.
Just moolah mush.
We take flour and water, mix it together. Boom. What you got? Pancakes without
syrup
the
sandwiches. Syrup sandwiches for everybody.
Yeah. What you know about mayonnaise sandwiches? Who need meat?
We used to have to do homework on syrup sandwiches.
You did homework? What do you mean?
Meaning you didn't have no food nutrients stimulating your brain.
I wonder why you get a 65 in every class.
You wonder why you stop halfway through. That syrup hit your brain like, yo, I can't do this no more.
We had sugar. We had Cheerios kids energy. We like in a fight, Sean would be real good on his feet for like the first 30 seconds. Then that hunger kick in. And they grab his little ass and just swing him
about. We didn't have enough meat. To put nobody in a headlock.
No protein.
Not one that keep them in there.
We ate like birds. Just
you know what's
bread.
Funny? When they say what they say, sometimes you think they're cracking jokes, but Damon ain't smiling. He's like, no protein. He's making it all serious. Syrup something. Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Damon had one tear in his eye like that little Indian on the horse.
So when y'all go on tour, who goes first? How do y'all determine who goes?
I go first because I piss everybody off.
Yeah. We switch it up. Marlon has the consistent first spot. We're going to switch it up, though.
Yeah, because we got to make him stronger.
Because Damon went last the last two times. I'm going to go last this weekend.
Uh-huh.
And then Keenan's going to go last another half of the week.
Keenan's on the tour too?
Yeah. We're bringing everybody.
We doing it. This
oh
is
my
real.
Gosh.
This is like, real, folks.
Look, you're getting four brothers for the price of one. This is the best discount.
You
niggas
sound
is going
like a
crazy right now.
You made it sound like
you get four for one? You throwing a nephew, I'll be at every show.
You made it sound like the 99 cent store tour.
Well, yeah, hold on, my daughters, real quick. Tell them the story when I saw Keenan over at Whole Foods in Tarzana.
When you see Keenan in Whole Foods.
Come here. This is a true story.
Well, I was drinking a smoothie. So was he. Whole Foods has really good smoothies.
They do.
And then he saw them in the aisle and chased them down.
Oh my God.
It was kind of embarrassing.
Was you screaming?
He looked like a little boy.
Hilarious.
And, I bugged out.
Yeah, it was like the pasta aisle too. He just wanted to buy something.
They're chilling in front of the gluten-free pasta talking.
Yeah, I felt like I had a moment. This wasn't that long ago. Y'all had just came by the show, and I realized how weird it must have felt for him. I said, "Oh, yo, your brothers just came by the show. Maybe that'd be a connection." He's right. Like, "You still doing the show?" I said, "Yeah." He said, "More money."
Hilarious.
Yeah, man. The Wayans brothers are here. I want to open up the phone lines, 888-742-3345.
Don't ask me no weird ass questions.
Okay, all right. Don't none.
Jack,
can we start?
Oh, God.
Let me say my part.
What?
About the only one that had some heart. It took some time for the heart to come, but it's here.
Now everybody's in fear.
Slashing through the door with that roar.
Bringing an end to this gold chain war. What you saw,
Chaos One is now seeing
another fly human being.
That was from my wife and kids. Damon Wayans here. Sean and Marlon Wayans are here as well. The Wayans brothers, they're on tour right now. That was an excerpt from my wife and kids that came out back in 2001.
Was
wow.
it?
Right yeah. there, back then. And yeah. Man, that was I think you threw a curveball with that show because it had a lot of family values.
Yeah. I was like, who the hell producing this? It's the same dude that did Handyman? Are you kidding me?
I wanted Marlon's Michael stupid. Kyle to be Handyman.
Right? That was your intent, though, right?
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. I was telling Sean and Marlon that I met with Bill Cosby before I did TV. And he said, this is what you do. He said, you go in and you fire the writers. You tell them they're all fired. Now, try and keep your job. And I was like, wow. That's how he did it. And so
you make them right nervous. You're crying at their desk. Lick butt, dog.
No, but he was just saying you basically have to really kind of make sure that they understand this is your vision, not their vision. Because once you give it up to them, then you're going to be very unhappy with the with
keep
the
your standards high.
So that was, you know, wow. Mr. Cos. So it was nice to have his blessings too.
Yeah, he sat me and Sean down.
I don't like the little one that puts his foot in the mouth. I don't understand why would you put your foot in your mouth. Now, I seen Mo Money and I didn't understand why the little boy would come in, grab his foot, and put the toe in the mouth.
Yeah.
What would Bill say if he watched Haunted House? You know,
did Sean give
it up? I've been watching The Family for quite some time, and I don't understand why the younger one continues to have things be put in his rectum. It's a place where things are supposed to come out of. He's putting things in.
He makes the moles on my face itch. My left eye leaks when I see him.
one of your brothers, man. I gotta get this out. You guys are performing where? Y'all got a lot of dates.
We are performing tomorrow night, July 18th at the Foxwoods Casino in
Connecticut.
Connecticut. What is it? Massachusettshunga or something?
Nantucket,
Massachusetts.
It's in
Connecticut. Yeah, it's in Connecticut, right. Connecticut at the Foxwoods Resort Casino.
I'm confused now. I don't know where I'm going.
Nantucket or something.
Well, you know what? I actually got it. July 18th at the Foxwoods Resort and Casino in Connecticut.
What part of Connecticut?
They'll find that. That's where you're confusing people, dude.
Yeah. Saturday, July 19th at the NYCB Theater in Westbury, New York.
Yes.
Sunday, July 20th at the Borgata Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City.
Nice.
Damn, yes. I want to go to that one.
And then August 2nd and 1st, we'll be back here in New Jersey. We'll be at the
NJ PAC.
Here we go.
That's the one I'm going to be at. That's Dallas G from my house.
And then Philadelphia, y'all going to Philadelphia Saturday, August 2nd at the Tower Theater.
Yes. So
y'all have just a website that people could go to?
You could check my Instagram on my Twitter, at Marlon Wayans, on my Facebook fan page. You could like it, at Marlon Wayans. And I'm going, I keep posting.
Like me at Damon K. Wayans.
No, but you could hit him at Damon K. Wayans. Hit Sean at Sean_Wayans. We keep posting the dates ourselves. We got to put up a website just to let people know where it's at. Okay, we will.
All right.
Okay, and lastly, I want to promote my show, Funniest Wins.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. Funniest Wins.
What a segue.
Funniest Wins comes on 10 o'clock on TBS. It's a competition comedy reality show called Funniest Wins, and it's basically trying to fund the funniest 360 comedian out there. Somebody could do stand-up, sketch, viral videos, vines, musical parody. This week's episode, we're roasting Ray J. Him and his dick get it. So make sure y'all tune in. This
Can
one
you
girl.
Say that?
This one girl said to Ray J.
I was like, "What? You didn't hit no button, dude. What's up?
This is the cleanest we ever did on here."
Yeah.
This one girl said about Ray J's dick. She said his dick was so crooked that she saw it on Sesame Street trying to teach the kids the letter S. That made me laugh. So we roasting him this week on Funniest Wins. You gotta tune in. It is a special episode. So please. Check it out.
Man, TBS. Very funny.
Yes.
You done made a lot of money in the past year and a half.
I'm trying to catch up to Damon.
That's what it is.
Damon got all. Look at it. You got designer
I'm
pajamas.
Broke. I'm on tour with y'all. That was mean. I'm kidding.
Hey, we got Jay on the line from Queens. Jay,
what up,
man?
What up, Jay?
Jay, how you doing?
Everybody.
Go ahead, man.
What up, Jay?
Well, Jay, what's up?
I just wanted to take it back, man. Back in the days with the Wayans Brothers show, man, it's people still upset that show ain't on no more.
They were not as upset as they were when it was on. Everybody was picking at us, boy. They hated me and Sean.
Actually, no. The audience.
And then they was going, them coons got to stop this.
You know what, though? The audience loved us. It was those, it was the groups.
The groups, yeah.
It was
that was trying to produce our show.
It was the
hated us.
It was the bougie niggas. The real brothers loved us.
Yeah, they loved it.
The bougie negroes was like, no.
I didn't know that. Y'all had backlash?
We had blacklash. Yeah, but it wasn't black people. It was the organizations that tried to
the NAACP.
Yeah, trying to get us to let them produce it. Yeah. That was
a funny ass show, man.
It was, and it was a positive show. It was about two brothers trying to make it in the world, not doing crime, not doing nothing.
But
bad.
The boy would have his foot in his mouth, eating cereal in a tub where his penis lies.
Why is the boy on fire?
Would he jump through the roof of the house with sneakers coming down? I don't understand why. And I caught flack for mush mouth. This guy is the living mush mouth. He's watermelon mouth.
Your show is on Centric, though. People can watch it now.
Our show is everywhere. It's on Centric. It's on MTV, too. There needs to be another show like that. We actually were talking about coming back and doing a sitcom again, me and Sean.
I love to see that, man. That was funny, man. Hey, we got John Bravo on the line from Dallas. John Bravo, what up, man?
Hey, what up with this way, everybody? What's up with it, man?
What's up, man?
Hey, I just wanted to say, man, I watch Don't Be a Menace every day. That shit still crack me the fuck up. I just want to say, it's good to see the whole family just strive and progress together. You know what I'm saying? That's a real good look. You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up, man.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you, brother.
Oh, yeah. I got to get a job between watching the show.
I know. I was about to say, all you do is wake and bake. I've been stuck in this bed smoking this blunt for the last 16 years.
Wake and bake.
And I never, my mama say, nigga, get out. But till then, I got to just watch Don't Be a Menace, man.
We love you, dude.
Man, let's take a listen to Don't Be a Menace, and then we're going to open up the phone lines, too. We got more with the Wayans Brothers, 888-742-3345. Swain in the Morning, Wayans Brothers are here.
That was another hot one.
Right, all the white girls out there, man. We had Terry Crews up here singing this, man, and it was
love that dude.
Oh man, Terry, isn't he?
He's amazing.
Making my way downtown.
Are we back on?
We're back on. Hey, thank you. Welcome to the show, Marlon.
Thank you. I'm sorry.
Good to have you here.
Sorry, I was tweeting about your show and promoting it. That's all.
Oh, okay.
But that's okay. I'll gladly stop, though, Sway. No, you ain't got the answer, Sway. You ain't got the answer, Sway. You ain't got the answers.
That was a funny moment right there.
You ain't got the answers, Sway.
You ain't got the answers.
Hold on, stop. Stop.
Now, you know when you play that with him, and, you know when him and Kim be arguing, you be like, you ain't got the answers, Kim.
And it ain't no Ralph, though.
Wait, hold up. That was funny to the Wayans?
Oh, my God. We were screaming.
Oh, good, man. I made it, yo.
He was so mad. We were screaming. And you were just so calm.
And I could just see your calm.
Calm, but like, I'll fight you if I have to.
But I don't want to.
Don't make me take my hat off.
I'm a positive brother.
I got weapons up under there.
I'm a positive brother. Please. Don't take me back.
You don't know the things I did
sweat.
To have to grow my dreads. That was I was trying to become something different. Please don't make me kill a friend.
Halfway, halfway.
Wow, you know you made it when the Wayans Brothers.
Huh? We were screaming.
Oh, I was rolling. Man, I had to play that back.
Yeah, man.
You know how you get that Charlie horse up here? That's how we were laughing. Like, wow, I can't believe this is happening.
That's great, man. That's beautiful, man.
Wow, yeah, this is great.
Yeah, because they mentioned fighting and it made me just start thinking, you know, like you growing up in a house with a lot of brothers and sisters, me and my brothers and sisters, we jump people. If one had a fight.
Oh, could we jump? We was roaches on molasses. If Sean was fighting, oh my God, I would jump.
Yeah,
I remember
jumped,
one time
yeah.
I jumped on a guy, I punched him in his eye, I twisted his eye and I kicked him. And I ran. And
that's how the fight started.
That's how the fight started.
Then I got punched
in
my face.
Right to Sean. I always find the biggest dude, fight him, and be like, bop, one punch, and just turn around and go, Sean! But Sean would have giants.
Then I'd fight him, and then we'd end up having to jump him. The
my
family
sister would
jump.
Kick him. Yeah. Like, for real. The dude was like, yo, it's like fighting an octopus. Everybody, like, everybody jump in. My nephew bit him.
They always try to hold off the other Wayne Wang. They call us Wayne Wang. Yo, the Wayne Wang try to jump you, hold him back.
But would you guys comedy jump somebody then? Like, if a comedian came
of course,
in?
Of course.
Damon even said, oh, yeah.
Oh, Damon jumped in on
we
that
go one. Back to and sketch then just to do them.
Right. And then we got my kids and their kids. It just the bench is too deep.
Yeah, you be fighting all of
Kevin
your
Hart,
life.
Kevin Hart has tapped Spurs. Out several times.
Oh, absolutely.
Kevin Hart tapped out?
He's like, yo, there's too many of them. Too many of them. On Twitter, we used to go at it. And then my little nephew Damon Jr. get in. This is like, yo, okay.
Who the Kevin Hart's done so well, man, for you guys to you kind of paved the way for a lot of guys who are doing well. Dave Chappelle, you know, when you look at Dave Chappelle's show and then you look at Living Color, you can see the influences that it had. And I was watching the Richard Pryor show,
brilliant,
and saw that influence that it had. How exciting is comedy? I feel like comedy is like in a great place right now.
It's in a great place, but a lot of people are afraid.
Yeah, we have to fight for it.
You got the thought police out there, you know, stopping you from really having a point of view about stuff. You know, anything they don't like, they shut down.
Please don't have it here on the show because people are listening, and I want them to come to our show. Keep it friendly, Damon. Now's not the time, please. The white man's watching.
That's the thought police talking.
That's the thought police?
Yeah, he's afraid that he's gonna lose a Twitter follower.
Right.
Say Negro, the other word.
Yeah, but Damon's right. It is.
It's hard for a comedian because, you know, you got you got the 24-hour
news cycle. You
gotta
say fuck them. That's all.
That's it.
Yeah, but then.
Hey, Marlon, what you think? Fuck you. That's what I'm saying.
And then apologize.
That's
sorry,
Marlon.
Guys.
That's Marlon. Yeah. Thought police.
Yeah.
You can say fuck.
Sean
say,
and Damon.
But what kind of stuff, Damon? Like, give me an example. What kind of stuff that they used
well,
to
like
do
Michael Richards. Michael Richards really in you know looking
back.
No, look, let's talk about Donald Sterling.
Okay.
The fact that this guy said, first of all, he's old. He don't even know that Chicky Witt is a dude.
So, he hasn't gotten a second base yet.
Yeah. So
he's got AIDS.
It's like, yeah, he's got AIDS. But the thing is,
he got dementia, the only word he remembers is nigga.
Yeah. No, he should be able to be. He should be able to be racist at home.
Yeah.
Wallace,
you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. At home, I hate white people. Mm-hmm. But I don't want nobody to record that and put it out there.
Right. Damon, it's recorded and put out there right now. Just for the record, I do love white people. No, whether I'm home or out or away.
No, but
or whether I'm at a rally. I do love white people.
Wallace, stupid. Yeah.
Even at the Million Man Watch.
I may hang out with the Panthers, but I... It's only because we're
that's
because
they're hanging me.
How cool white people are the in leather jackets.
No, but it's that. That's the fear that people have. Is you have to you'll have to apologize for having a thought. You know, Tracy Morgan. Mm. You know, you got a bunch of people who had to come out and say I'm sorry, and not just I'm sorry. Have to go do a tour. The I'm sorry tour. And it's like, to me, that's not, you know, there's certain places
gay people
where
you know what?
By the way, get well, Tracy. I love you, brother.
We love you,
get
Trace.
Get well soon.
Yeah. But
I'm sorry, Tracy.
Yeah. No, but listen, you there's certain places there shouldn't be cameras. One is
the comedy club,
the church, and the war room. And it's just for the people in the room. It's not for everybody to see because out of context, it looks crazy.
Yeah.
Comedians are crazy.
And a strip club when you got girls dancing on you with naked and you paid your good hard-earned money. And yeah, they may be doing things they ain't supposed to be doing, but that's my business and that's why I pay that, you know, the thousands of dollars. So when that tape come out, I just want to apologize in advance. To
there you go. She ain't 15.
She ain't. She no 15-year-old got a pussy like that.
What?
What?
And we're going to go to commercial on that.
That's what am I talking about?
We're going to come right back now. Tracy, you
I meant vagina.
You know it. All right. So I wanted to talk about the other whack side of the entertainment industry, which is when you climb
I want to talk about why you standing over there when you know you got that big old ass. Bring
here
that over here.
No.
They gave you and your ass your own booth. Come bring that out here so we can all see.
What whack side?
Thank you for recognizing, Marley.
Recognizing it? Met me downstairs.
You know. I can't do this one.
He ain't right.
Now, what's the whack side of the show business?
Okay, so we spoke about how you have all the orthodox critics, but then also when you reach all the ladders of success, you have a lot of people who maybe you help employ or just family members that call you, and now all of a sudden they feel entitled to a piece of the pie.
Sound like you go through something personal, baby?
Hold on.
Who asked you for a loan?
They go flip on me so quickly. But I bring that up because I saw a story with Lady Gaga, and she has her assistant who's trying to sue her for $1 million. And the assistant is like, oh, she was overworking me. She has separation anxiety when she's sleeping. She tried to have me hold her in the middle of the night. And Lady Gaga's like, you a fucking hood rat. You didn't do nothing to deserve extra money.
Beyond that,
I don't care how hard the assistant worked. You ain't gonna make $1 million being an assistant. I'm sorry. You got, it's like, that's like just trying to find the easy way out. Sorry.
Yeah. Easy way out.
But that is whack, and yeah, those people exist, and that's why we keep our circle small.
Keep it in the family, right? The Wayans are here. You wanna talk with them, 888-742-3345. Let's take them back.
Damn, I should've broke that boy's back.
Yeah, you real tough
should
now.
Just punch him right in his face. Mm-hmm.
Shh. Hey, take those bananas.
Hey. I was from Beverly Hills Cops back in 1984, man. And I don't understand. I don't know if people now realize how gigantic Eddie Murphy became at that point.
Oh,
Eddie gave me that role. I didn't have to audition. That was the first thing I ever did.
Really?
Yeah, that was very cool.
It seemed like Eddie, like with Martin, yourself, Chris Rock, Eddie
opened the door for all of us.
Yeah, Eddie.
All of us.
Eddie is very generous.
You know, Richard Pryor, I guess, opened the door. Eddie came in and decorated the place.
Mm. Yeah.
I mean, and they just brought all of us in.
And he was very generous, too.
Extremely.
Yeah.
So you got paid well on that one.
No, just in terms of helping you out.
Helping, like, young comics.
You know, Keenan and Robert Townsend directing Raw. And
mm-hmm. Keenan used to write with him. And
Chris Rock. And stuff. You just name anybody young and black who was coming up at the time.
Eddie helped.
touched him somehow.
That's great. Yeah. Now, Keenan's not the oldest, right?
In our family.
Dwayne, yeah, Dwayne. We had a brother, Dwayne, who's the oldest, but he's gone.
Passed it.
He passed away.
I guess Keenan's the oldest now. By default. Sorry, Dwayne.
Marlon is so...
Should have stayed alive.
No, nobody else laughed in the family. But
well, we have to look at Marlon first and go, did this nigga really say this? And then we can laugh and go, it's Marlon.
How many times a day I'm throwing out the family with that look?
There you go, right?
What are you?
Keenan, man, is so brilliant to me. Like, did when y'all were younger, did y'all used to practice sketch comedy? At did he make y'all practice sketch comedy?
Our house was a sketch, dude. Yeah.
We 10 used to people in the neighborhood was a play sketch. This game called Make Me Laugh or Die.
That was fun.
So you had to stand up in front of all the kids and make us all laugh in unison. You couldn't just make one laugh. You had to make everybody laugh at the same time. If you didn't, then we all sat around and thought about what your die is. And so we'd pick something like, all right, you got to go drink daddy's last beer in front of him.
Or wake my father up out of his sleep.
Yeah.
And he had like 3 different jobs. He would come home late. It was always something dangerous.
Go fart in mama's face.
Right. Right. It was like that.
Who died the most? Who had the most dies?
We all died. It's hard to make
us laugh. The whole joke was not breaking so that we can do mean stuff to you.
Right.
Well, you guys ever like with all the kids are coming up and in comedy now. Will the whole clan, Wayans clan, ever do something together? Is that possible?
Yeah, man. They'll make a stage that big.
That's not a story.
That's like asking, is all of China going to get together and do a show?
With a different look. Each one of them have a different look.
Do one really hard math problem. Can China get together, do one hard math problem and solve it?
No, but there's so many. Like my son Damon Jr. does stand up. I got we got Shantae does stand up. You know, Lil G is doing acting improv.
Craig and Damien.
Mm-hmm. It's
our kids now. Yeah, it's crazy.
That's crazy, right? Williams brothers are here. We got my man Rob from Chicago on the line. Rob, good morning. How you doing?
What up, Rob?
Yo, you guys hear me?
Yeah, go ahead.
I saw you in the shower on the train.
You can't hear you.
What's up, man?
Yo, man, I just wanted to say, like, huge fan, been one since the beginning. I mean, like, I grew up in the 80s, so I kind of grew up on you guys, like, staying up late.
Oh, no wonder why your phone sound like that. It's a rotary.
He got a shoe phone.
A shoe phone.
All right, we got Juan from North Carolina on the line. Go ahead, Juan.
What's going on, Sway? What's going on, Wayne's brother?
What's happening, man?
How y'all doing, man? I just want to say I grew up watching y'all on A Living Color with Dame and Sean on the turntables, and I grew up watching y'all movies. And one of my favorite movies was Major Pain growing up, and I still think it's the most hilarious movie I ever saw, me being in the military and all, so I think it's funny as hell.
I appreciate that, turd.
I just want to thank you guys for so many years of laughter, and I just want to congratulate y'all on y'all's success and keep doing what y'all doing, man.
We appreciate you, my brother. Thank you for the love, man.
We got Jim from Compton on the line. Go ahead, Jim.
Hey, what's up with you?
What up, Mike?
All right. Hey, man, the Wayne's, man.
The whinings, man. When did y'all leave gospel to do comedy? I just want to say everybody that call into y'all show sound high.
Hang on, like
newly high.
Hang on, let him speak. Go ahead, man.
Hey, you damn sure calling the right too, because I'm blown.
Hey. We got Knowledge on the line from Georgia.
Oh, you know he's smoking weed.
Yeah, yeah. Knowledge, good morning.
Anybody name himself Knowledge?
You there, Knowledge?
Knowledge!
He don't know.
He don't know.
Evan, you there?
Hey, yeah, Evan's here.
What's happening?
Hey, man, I'm a big fan of the whole family, man. From everything you guys did, from I'm Gonna Get You Sucker to Living Color and Wayne Head. I could go on and on with all the stuff you guys done, but I just wanted to tell a quick story. I'm here in Las Vegas, and I'm a production assistant, and I'm about, like, 5'8", and about as dark as Charlie Murphy with some dreads, right? And I get a call, like, a week ago to do a stand-in job for Damon Wayans Jr.
What you gonna play? His doodoo?
His shadow.
His doodoo.
He gonna play his shadow.
What shadow?
Marlon is
You gonna play his dick in the scene? What's going on?
Hang on, Mom. What?
What?
I was cast by a white person, so they're like, oh, what, you're not the right color brown?
He even made you laugh, like, I don't look nothing like this brother.
Is this for the Nike commercial?
No, it was actually for Sharknado promo for Let's Be Cops.
Oh, okay.
I
did you do it, or you just got the call?
I got the call, and I went in, and they're like, this brother.
They tell you too dark?
Uh-huh.
How does that make you feel, brother?
Oh, he's like, he don't care. I got paid to be ugly. I don't care.
But the good news is Kevin Hart's doodles being canceled next week, so I will be there.
Macadon is in Atlanta. Go ahead, man. What up, bro?
Just wanted to say, Sway, long time listener, first time caller. Can I please be a citizen?
Yo, Heather, Macadon, you are officially a citizen.
A Sway in the morning.
There it is, bro.
Yo, to the Wayans brothers, I'm married. I've been married for 20 years, but I do have to say, watching Eddie Murphy Raw for the first time, I laughed my ass off. Looking at it 20 years later, it is a marriage tool. I had no idea that you guys were behind the writing on that joint. Man, mad props.
No, that was Eddie Murphy's. Kenan helped produce it, and he wrote the opening sketch with Eddie. That was
But that's all Murphy.
That's all Murphy. Eddie Murphy.
That was all Murphy.
Here's the thing.
And I love Raw, too.
I didn't know where he was going when he first said, I've been married for 20 years, but I didn't know where he was going. But I would leave my wife to fuck one of y'all. I said, this got real strange, real fucking strange.
Dedicated fan, man. Hey, Moshe, what you want to say?
Hey, I just wanted to say, man, I love y'all. I love him from the beginning, but how come no one ever talks about Requiem for a Dream? I mean, that was Academy Award-winning I give him mad props for that shit.
Thank you, brother. Thank you.
What drug were you on?
Thank you, man. hopefully one day I'll do another drama. Damon got a drama in his closet that honestly should have won an Academy. One day he'll release it to video. Probably when I die, he'll release it.
And that's what I'm waiting for.
But it was, to me, the best performance I ever did. It's in his closet, though.
It's called Behind the Smile.
Yeah, it was a dope movie.
He's brilliant in this movie.
Really?
I don't know why.
Because you're crazy.
Yeah, I don't know why.
You're crazy, dude.
Dave Chappelle loves this movie. A lot of comedians love this movie.
Man, it's my favorite.
Why won't you release it?
It's crazy and it's insane.
What did Chris Rock have to say about it, Sean?
Chris Rock loved it.
I didn't fucking see it.
Wow. What did Bill Cosby say about it, Sean?
The boy put his foot in his mouth again.
Pick a scene out the movie.
I don't remember.
What about Cat Williams?
I'm telling you, I love the shit all the way through. From here to the floor, I laugh my ass off.
He's actually in it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Cat's in it.
Cat's in it? What, did Kevin Hart see it? Did Kevin Hart see it?
I don't think Kevin saw it.
I was waiting for Sean.
Kevin Hart seen it, but he was sitting next to Cat because I can't do Kevin.
Kevin, what do you think? The nigga's not talking to me.
Man, the Wangin brothers, man. Get these dudes a round of applause. Don't forget, tomorrow night, Foxwoods Resort and Casino in Connecticut. Saturday, it'll be at NYCB Theater in Westbury, New York. Sunday, Borgata Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City. Friday, August 1st, what's that, New Jersey Pack?
NJ Pack.
NJ Pack in Newark.
It's in Newark, yeah.
August 2nd, Tower Theater in Philadelphia.
And also, make sure y'all watch Funniest Wins every Friday night on TBS. It's a very funny show. Funniest Wins, I produce it, write it, I'm on it, host it. And lastly, follow us on me, Marlon Wayans, at Marlon Wayans on Twitter, at Marlon Wayans Instagram. Follow my Facebook fan page. Follow Damon K. Wayans, at Damon K. Wayans on Twitter.
They done forgot.
Sean, at Sean Wayans.
They ran out of applause in the background.
All right, just follow me then.
All right. Hey, gentlemen, thank you for your contribution.
Thank you, man.
Thank you for
always
your
love.
Work. Always love,
thank
man.
Thank you, man. Always.
Thank you for the support, man.
It's Sway in the Morning, only on Shea 45.